So you may have recently heard about the controversy currently going on between the United States and Turkey about the F-35 and the S-400 system. There are some technical elements that are quite interesting, and I'm going to discuss them right now. Welcome to Millennium 7 Star, the channel that helps you make sense of military history and military technology. So which are the points of the controversy? Turkey is a member of the F-35 program, is building some parts of the plane, is also supposed to host one of the maintenance centers for the planes in Europe, and has ordered quite a good chunk of planes. But Turkey also has acquired, and the first deliveries should happen soon, and from the time of filming this video, it also has acquired the S-400 surface-to-air missile system, which is considered one of the best in the world, and it is Russian. Now, the United States are concerned that, through the sensor of the S-400, the Turks will be able to characterize the F-35 radar signature and electromagnetic signature, and eventually this information may end up being delivered to Russia. As usual, I don't care about the political element behind this, but I think it is interesting to understand what it really means characterize the plane. Point number one. In a radar echo, there is more information than just the direction and the distance. The tail of the plane, the engines, the fuselage, the air intakes, the underwing pylons, all these elements of the plane have their own specific reflection. The waveform of the echo received is a composition of the reflections of a different part of the plane. Studying these reflections and having a library of threats, something that the F-35 has and does very well, you can, just from the echo, actually identify the target. So what the US is concerned is that through the S-400 radars, the Turks will be able to identify how the F-35 reflects radar signals in all aspects, and this information may end up in the wrong hands. This kind of information is important because you can identify a plane, a type of plane, directly from the characteristics of its radar echo. This is an important help in identifying if the plane is a friend, a foe, or it is neutral. If it is not possible to identify a plane electronically as a potential threat, potential enemy, normally the rules of engagement prescribe to have a visual contact with the plane, which means pretty much throwing away every beyond visual range fighting capability, any long range capability that you may have built in your weapons. The second element is that every plane emits electromagnetic energy, emits from the radar, emits from the radios, emits from any other apparatus that is on board of the plane. The F-35 is a stealth plane, and it has been built to severely limit the quantity of energy and to be very directional in some of the emissions in order to be very difficult to be characterized. But nonetheless, it will emit radio energy, and this can be received by adequate sensors. And again, this picture of the type of energy, of the type of emission, the frequency, the pattern, the pulses that is emitted by a plane is used to characterize the plane and identify the plane again as a friend, a foe, or neutral. So we are exactly in the same situation as before, in which knowing this kind of data can lead to identifying a plane much more easily. Particularly in the case of the F-35, which is a stealth plane, it is even more important because what the enemy may see trying to identify the F-35 on radar is a very feeble, very small echo, and being able to characterize that echo as not just being a spurious echo, being a small plane or being whatever else, but being an F-35 by its specific characteristics, it's a big advantage. And by the way, this is the reason why you see the F-35 quite often flying around with radar reflectors that enhance the radar reflection of the plane. In this way, potentially hostile sensor which track the plane won't be able to tell the true characteristics of the plane and won't be able to identify the plane from those. So I believe that the key takeaway is that electronic warfare is very complicated and information is king. So if you're interested in learning something more about stealth and radars and guidance and stuff like that, please click on the videos beside me. In the meanwhile, thank you for watching and goodbye.